10 Famous People Who Hates The X Factor. Hey everyone, and welcome back to The Screening. The X Factor is one of those shows people either love or despise, and those who aren't fans usually hate it with a burning passion. A list of its biggest critics feature a couple of famous faces, including several stars who were contestants, judges, and performers on this hit show. Let's take a look at 10 Famous People Who Hate The X Factor. Before we list some of the nastiest things ever said about this show, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Number 10. Sharon Osbourne. Sharon Osbourne's time on The X Factor was marked with several controversies, and so was her imminent departure. She was one of the judges who were on the panel from the very start, but left the show a few years later and returned for a couple of seasons in the future. By the time season 15 rolled around, it seemed her exit was final, and she bid a farewell to The X Factor in a moving statement. The outspoken TV personality said that she felt that she was no longer needed after seeing new judges finding their rhythm and doing brilliantly. But some people felt Sharon's not being honest. Osbourne described The X Factor as a stupid karaoke and said she chose to skip the live audition since she couldn't stand untalented contestants screaming in her face. She wasn't too kind to her co-star Simon Cowell either and said he's a fame monster who would do anything to get his fat face on TV. Number 9. Calvin Harris. It's not unusual to see industry veterans making fun of The X Factor, but it's pretty surprising to hear modern-day artists taking their side. That's why many people felt Calvin Harris was barking up the wrong tree when he started slamming this talent show. He made a couple of jarring comments after his stint on the show stirred some controversy. Harris interrupted a live performance by the novelty double act Jedward in 2009 when he made fun of their unusual hairstyles by storming the stage and dancing around with a pineapple. Harris later explains that he wanted to make a mockery of the show because it's a joke and should be treated as such. He also criticized Cowell for encouraging generic pop music and said he's not really a music fan because he's not using his power to put creative artists into the spotlight. Despite the pineapple incident and the several hurtful comments, Harris was invited back in 2016 and accepted the offer. So it's safe to say it's all water under the bridge. Number 8. Elton John. Sir Elton John is another music legend who had nothing nice to say about The X Factor or its creator, Simon Cowell. The veteran singer described talent shows such as this one as boring and brain-crippling because they're TV entertainment and not a search for real talent. Sir Elton admitted that he probably wouldn't have lasted for too long if he competed on The X Factor, but he wasn't bothered by it. The 5-time Grammy winner expressed his belief you can only sustain a career by paying your dues in small clubs, and The X Factor was the polar opposite of that since it offered a shortcut to stardom. Another major issue Elton John had with this show is the fact it didn't properly nurture the careers of its contestants. He felt that they are not treated as real artists, but products that are humped and dumped as soon as a fresh new face comes along. Sir Elton wondered what's going on with these people after they disappear from the spotlight and why they aren't touring and learning what it actually means to sing live. Number 7. Noel Gallagher. The Oasis frontman is another rock star whose comments about The X Factor proved to be a little bit controversial. Noel Gallagher was pretty inconsistent while criticizing this show because he walked a thin line between slamming it and endorsing it. The singer stated this show has absolutely nothing to do with music and everything to do with television, and had a thing or two to say about the people on the judging panel, especially Danny Minogue. Gallagher mocked this Australian singer by joking she wouldn't know talent if it kicked her and had no business judging other people. Despite hating the show as a whole, he seemed to be fond of Simon Cowell. Unlike most people in the industry, Gallagher felt that the music industry would be a better place if it had more people like him. It was even rumored Cowell wanted Gallagher to replace him as a judge while he went absent from the panel, but the Oasis frontman declines the offer. Number 6. Sting. With 16 Grammy Awards under his belt, Sting is arguably one of the biggest rock stars of all time. After almost 5 decades in the music industry, he knows how to recognize true talent when he sees one, and he doesn't believe it can be found on The X Factor. The Police frontman had nothing nice to say about this show and described it as a soap opera which has nothing to do with music. The famous musician stated that The X Factor put music back decades because it encouraged contestants to conform to stereotypes. Sting felt young hopefuls on the show are constantly facing humiliation and being asked to fit into the mold instead of creating their unique signature. He also had a thing or two to say about Cowell and his buddies. He describes their behavior as appalling because they have no recognizable talent apart from self-promotion. Sting believes that none of the contestants on this show will go anywhere, but some of them proved him wrong in the years to come. Number 5. Annie Lennox. The song Sweet Dreams Are Made of This perfectly encapsulates the spirit of The X Factor, but the woman who wrote it disagrees with everything this show represents. The Eurythmics singer openly slams this talent search in reality shows in general. She described them as dangerous and cruel spectacles owned and stitched up by puppet masters and said she would never even consider being a judge on one. Lennox's criticism wasn't coming from nowhere. She was one of Cowell's former clients before anybody was anybody and knows how he operates. The Scottish pop queen was never in love with the idea of having a panel of judges who are playing God and decided what's good and what isn't. Lennox also didn't seem to enjoy the humiliation factor that's a crucial part of talent competition shows. She felt that they were guilty of destroying the self-esteem of a whole generation of kids who went through the audition process. Number 4. Moby. In addition to being one of the leading figures on the dance scene back in the 90s, Moby wrote music for the likes of David Bowie, Pet Shop Boys, and Britney Spears, so it's safe to say he has a sharp eye for talent. Unlike the majority of the X Factor critics, Moby was honest enough to admit that this show produced a couple of talented individuals, but they just weren't his cup of tea. The famous DJ described this show as awful because the judges spend too much time telling contestants how they should sound or look. He felt Simon Cowell is a very smart businessman, but he couldn't understand why he needed any more money after earning hundreds of millions by judging and producing several shows similar to The X Factor. Number 3. Cheryl Cole. One of the easiest ways to start hating The X Factor is being part of the judging panel and getting fired with no explanation. That's exactly what happens to Cheryl Cole. At one point, Cowell described her as the best judge he ever worked with, and even decided she would be a good addition to the judging panel of the American version. He quickly changed his mind and sacked Cheryl after a 3-week stint. Cole was so furious after getting the sack that she sent him an angry text cursing the show and the network behind it. She also used a couple of F-bombs to describe her hatred for the big hair and all orange and purple outfits she had to wear while filming it. Cheryl later regretted this move and explained it happened at a low point in her life. The British singer said that she went through hell after Simon broke the news to her and admitted that his decision literally drove her mad. Looking back at her bad behavior, she felt he was right to get rid of her, but wished he did it face to face. Despite the fact she couldn't stand the X Factor at the time, Cheryl eventually returned as a judge of the UK version. Number 2. Simon Fuller. Even before the whole world got to learn of what the X Factor is all about, there was one person who hated it from the bottom of their heart. The creator of the Idol franchise, Simon Fuller, was so furious after seeing Cowell launching a show that's essentially a carbon copy of Pop Idol that he decided to take legal action. It seemed like Cowell was biting the hands that feeds him because he found fame thanks to his role as a judge on Pop Idol. That was where he learned the ropes of the talent show business before deciding to break free and do it on his own. He described Fuller's accusations as totally and utterly ridiculous, since The X Factor wasn't the first talent competition show with a similar format, and they've been around long before Fuller came up with Pop Idol. Number 1. Adam Miller. There's no one in this world that hates The X Factor more than the former contestants who were mocked on live TV by the judging panel. Adam Miller is a case in point, and he was so furious after being humiliated during his audition that he decided to take legal action. He sued the show after being manipulated into auditioning with a promise this show could change his life forever. Miller knew his voice wasn't that great from the get-go, but producers tricked him into believing in himself. The disgraced singer said they gave him a bit of self-confidence before deliberately stripping it away to make good TV. They even asked him to perform as a comedy Britney Spears tribute act, the same way he did during his Britain's Got Talent audition. By the time he realized they were setting him up for failure, it was too late. He was already the laughingstock of the whole nation. Thank you very much for watching today's video. Make sure to subscribe to our channel for more amazing content, and don't forget to check out one of the other two videos on your screen. Thank you.